Greetings. Thank you, brother, for your question. Because there are many good people who do good to mankind and help poor and fight for justice and freedom, but do not believe in Jesus, do they enter heaven? I think it is dangerous to focus on a word, any word, such as Christian. I do not believe the title makes any difference to Yahweh God, but I do think that Yeshua, or Jesus, made very clear statements about this situation. John 14:6, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. There is no ambiguity in that statement, brother. Jesus is very clear that he is the only way. But he does not define exactly what that means in this context, does he? He does expound more details in other contexts. Jesus describes a requirement of being born again of the Spirit of God. John 3:1. Now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus at night and said, Rabbi, we know you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one could perform the signs you are doing if God were not with him. Jesus replied, Truly, truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again. How can a man be born when he is old? Nicodemus asked. Can he enter his mother's womb a second time to be born? Jesus answered, Truly, truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Flesh is born of flesh, but spirit is born of the Spirit. Do not be amazed that I said, You must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes. You hear its sound, but you do not know where it comes from or where it is going. So it is with everyone born of the Spirit. And the apostles taught what was needed to obtain salvation. Romans 10:9. Because if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. The word Lord, in the expression Jesus is Lord, means more than simply master or leader. We should understand Jesus is God, come in the flesh. This is the message of the prophets. For with the heart one believes and is justified, and with the mouth one confesses and is saved. Jesus teaches that he, Jesus, will be the judge of all men. John 5:22. Furthermore, the Father judges no one, but has assigned all judgment to the Son. And this time of judgment is described further. Matthew 7:21. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only he who does the will of my Father in heaven. Many who say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and in your name drive out demons and perform many miracles? Then I will tell them plainly, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness. So, knowing Jesus, or more accurately, Jesus knowing you, is important as well as doing the will of the Father. But our good deeds alone are not a path to salvation. If they were, Christ died in vain. Isaiah 64:6. For all of us have become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy garment, and all of us wither like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. All of our good deeds, those we think add to our righteousness, are unclean to God. We cannot earn our salvation with our good works. Ephesians 2:8, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this not from yourselves. It is the gift of God," meaning the faith to believe is a gift from God, "not by works, so that no one can boast." I would be offering false hope, brother, if I said I thought anyone could obtain salvation through their good works. But the hope I do have is that someone with a heart that desires to do good deeds will recognize the truth when they hear of the love of Jesus and his sacrifice for all mankind. As Christians, it is not our responsibility to prejudge who may or who may not receive the gospel. It is our commission to preach the truth in love. Mark 16:15, "And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature." 2 Timothy 4:2, "Preach the word, be instant, in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort, with all longsuffering and doctrine." We must study the word of God, the message of the prophets, so that we are equipped. 2 Timothy 2:15, "Study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth." Rightly dividing means having the correct grasp of the meaning and interpretation. 1 Peter 3:15, "But in your hearts sanctify Christ as Lord, always ready for a defense to everyone asking you an account concerning the hope in you, yet with gentleness and fear," meaning always be ready to explain why you believe. Why do you have this hope in the gospel of Jesus Christ? But do it with gentleness and an awesome fear that this may be that other person's only chance to really hear the gospel. The message of Christ Jesus is the only hope for mankind. This should be the hope that is in us, and that we are aware is in us. Colossians 4:6, "Let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how to answer everyone." Getting back to your original question, because there are many good people who do good to mankind and help poor and fight for justice and freedom, but do not believe in Jesus, do they enter heaven? There are several meta concepts to address. This would seem to only apply to those who have never heard the name Jesus and the gospel message even mentioned. The Great Commission exists to share the information so that all may make an informed decision. So Christians are obligated to know the gospel clearly and then share it clearly with all possible patience. It seems unfair to our human judgment that some might not hear and yet be condemned. But I think that is a sad and weak diversion used by those who have heard. Boiled down, it is a judgment against God and exhibits the rebellion of the human heart. Hearts seeking the truth, even in a web of lies like Islam, are being answered, sometimes even by Jesus himself in dreams and visions. Revelation 3:20, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone should hear my voice, anyone in Islam, anyone in Buddhism, anyone that's atheist, if anyone should hear my voice and open the door, then I will come into him and will dine with him, and he with me." We cannot know what the heart of any other person truly desires. Hearts that desire truth are different from hearts that desire control. It is risky, at best, to reject the truth based on what one thinks is a clever argument. When we stand before God, all pretense of ignorance will immediately fade, and no clever argument will seem clever in the presence of His holiness. Any decision should be made, not knowing if another opportunity will ever be given. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.